All right, guys. So this part is going to be all about the products and adding products to our site and then also starting to display those products on the front end. This means we're going to be importing a CSV file, which I'll link in this lesson, as well as do a quick run through on adding products manually. But there's no shortage of resources out there on how to do that. Now, we're going to be doing other stuff like adding list grid switches to our product layouts. We're going to be doing a lot of fun stuff, and I am excited. So why don't we get cracking right now? Okay, so here we go. Last time we had finished setting up the entire environment that we're going to be working on. We're making sure the BodyCommerce, everything's installed, WooCommerce, and all that fun stuff. I want to draw your attention to this blog post I've got right here. This is one we've got a WooCommerce sample product CSV file. So if you don't have any products that you can load in really quickly, your own CSV file, something like that, just go to the link, download it, and import it as I'm going to be doing right now. Just simplifies the process, speeds it up. And like I mentioned, no shortage out there of teaching you how to manually add products to WooCommerce. So first things, I want to show you that indeed our database is empty. There's no products there, right? So how do we add products? Well, it's actually very convenient. We've downloaded our CSV file. So all we got to do is go ahead and click on Start Import here. Here from Start Import, I can go ahead and select my file. There we go. I just dragged mine over. You can click and choose. You can do whatever you want. Now, there's no other products in the database, so we don't need to worry about all of these other settings. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on Continue. It'll ask me if I want to map some fields, but this was an export directly from a WooCommerce database, so no need to go through that. But if a client provided a CSV file, sometimes you're going to have to map those fields. So I'm just going to go ahead and run the importer. And there we go. We've got our 16 products imported. So let's go check them out. Let's go to view. And here we can see everything's in here. Now, this file does have a good mix of variable products with different options, categories, as you can see right here, different stock statuses and stuff like that to really allow you some flexibility in seeing all the different scenarios with designing the site. Right. And then at client handle, of course, you'll go through and delete all of these products and put actual products in there. But that's how easy it is. Now, just to give you a quick overview of manually adding a product, I'll go ahead and click on Add New. I'm not going to actually add a product, but I'll give you an idea of how this is done. Right here, you've got the Add New. See, product name. Simple. You will put your description right here. A lot of this is going to be very easy to understand. And then right here, you're going to very importantly decide whether this is a simple product or a group product, the external affiliate product, or a variable product. You can also indicate whether it's a virtual downloadable product, and then you can deal with kind of the pricing here. If you're doing inventory management, that's all done right here. And if you do have a variable product, I just want to show this to you, is that when you come down here to variations, all your variations will show up here. And they usually derive from attributes that you set up. Now, again, no shortage out there of showing you how to do this process, as it's just basic WooCommerce. So no need for me to go through this. But if you're a newer WordPress user and definitely WooCommerce user, seek out those resources. I also have another tutorial series called Clone Any Online Store, where we kind of go through the process also. So that is going to be it for adding products. And one of the cool things we can check out right now here on the shop page, which is our front page, if I refresh that page now, bam, we've got all of our products showing. So now things are starting to take a little bit of shape. And coming up, we're going to be taking a look at some of the features in BodyCommerce and do a brief overview of where you're going to be finding different types of settings and things so that you're not lost or stuck in that respective thing. So why don't we go ahead and move on to that next.